I don't know where to start.
Let me help you.
You got this jackass out. Well, you got this jackass in Montana, right? You got this jackass in Montana. I'm on a roll, okay?
Let me be in my confused state for a little while.
Wow.
No, we're just going to sit back. Sit back. You got the jackass in Montana. He's asked a question about the Congressional Budget Office, and he loses it. And like, he's charged with assault. You got the CBO score that comes out, 23 million people kicked off of the Obamacare rolls. You got Comey apparently being duped by the FBI. You've got our intel agencies going after during the campaign, tracking down sources that are making contacts with the Trump campaign. Again, another absolutely crazy busy day.
We'll start again with what happened last night in Montana's special congressional election. Ben Jacobs is a reporter for The Guardian, and he approached Republican congressional candidate Greg Gianforte to ask him a question about the CBO score of the Republican health care bill.
What could go wrong?
Well, Jacobs says that Gianforte then body slammed him and broke his glasses.
This is a candidate on the eve of his election acting like a lunatic. And I think that, you know, and I saw Joe's tweets last night, and I think just this animalistic behavior out of our politicians, that they've become, you know, it's like, I don't want to reveal too much about my viewing habits, but it's something you see on Reno 911. I mean, it's just like a lunatic pulled over for swerving around and acting belligerent at a traffic stop. It's not the way anyone should expect someone who wants to represent their constituents.
And not exactly a gotcha
question. And anyone that thinks it's unfair or too early to draw a direct line between Donald Trump calling reporters enemies of the state and people beating up a working journalist is ridiculous. And I think the fact that you have a Fox crew bearing witness is just beautiful, exquisite irony, sort of defending the account of The Guardian. I think it's time for all journalists to sort of stand together. And I think that the White House thinks these are separate or isolated incidents, that they don't think they've created a climate where something like this could happen, is an unsustainable position.
What is an unsustainable position? And Mark Halperin, I've had some people this morning already say, well, you know, text me and say, well, how can you even try to connect this in any way with Donald Trump's behavior over the past year? It's very easy. You see somebody that's elected president of the United States that called the press enemies of the people several times, including in front of CPAC, who repeatedly verbally abused reporters, recklessly and irresponsibly in large arenas calling out people's name, recklessly and irresponsibly tweeting specific attacks about those journalists. And again, generally having a thuggish behavior and having people going out to the media yelling at them, even in the press corps. What do we expect? This guy already had a brush with the media before where he seemed to be threatening a reporter a couple of months back when somebody said, hey, what do we do about the press? How can we stop the press? And there was one person in the press there. He pointed at him and he said in a menacing way, well, there's more of us than there are of him. Basically, we've got him outnumbered. If you were a conservative, if you're a Trump supporter, and you're suggesting that the thuggish behavior from the president of the United States does not have an impact on people who are trying to emulate him, then you are clueless as to how politics work. You can blame it on Barack Obama's tan suit if you want to, but there is a straight line to this sort of thuggish behavior. And if Trump wants to disprove me, wants to prove me wrong, then call this guy out, say he's a punk, he should go to jail, and he should never be seated in Congress.
There's no doubt that the Republican Party is going to have to answer for this, including the leader of the Republican Party, whose rhetoric and behavior towards freedom of the press and journalists has created an environment where this kind of thing not only is echoed, but has appeal for a lot of supporters of in the conservative movement. This kind of thing has appeal. Even what this congressional candidate did, unfortunately, will have appeal for some people who don't like the press. I will say, just as a matter of sheer political reality, it's probably better for the Republican Party if he loses today. Because if he wins, they're all going to have to answer for it. They're all going to be asked about it. He will come to Washington as a symbol of not just disrespect towards the media, but out of control, violent behavior, disrespectful of and dangerous, and not paying proper heed to the importance of First Amendment in our society. So he may win. He'll probably win, but they're better off if he loses.
Well, yeah. And this Trump thuggishness, he will represent the thuggishness of Donald Trump towards the press, the thuggishness of Donald Trump toward the First Amendment, the thuggishness of Donald Trump towards courts, the thuggishness of Donald Trump, John Heilman, towards anyone who dares to challenge his ultimate authority. I agree with Mark. I don't think that's something that this Republican Party wants to be any part of. And please, again, for conservatives, you're not conservative if you support this sort of behavior. For Trumpists that are out there right now saying, oh, you can't connect this with Donald Trump's abuse of the media over the past year and a half. Please, that's just a joke. This sort of stuff didn't happen when George H.W. Bush was president of the United States. You didn't have Republicans beating up members of the press.
Thanks for checking out MSNBC on YouTube, and make sure you subscribe to stay up to date on the day's biggest stories. And you can click on any of the videos around us to watch more from Morning Joe and MSNBC. Thanks so much for watching.